Britney Spears look like and tribute. Start with, it was more lookalike stuff that I did. It was just right up my street, like acting, dressing up and sort of performing, I suppose. So I did the lookalike stuff for a little while, doing appearances, meet and greets and that sort of thing, photo shoots. And then from there, people were always saying, oh, do you sing as well? Do you dance? And I was like, no singing for me, thank you, no dancing. And then after a while, I thought, I'll give it a go. One of my friends was a choreographer, so I was like, oh, would you mind teaching me some of Britney's dance routines? And she sort of broke the routines down for me. It was really challenging at first, because it was something that I'd never done. I'd never done any dancing at all. So I'd got like two left feet, it was terrible. but over time I sort of learned. And then I thought, oh, should I give singing a go? Because everyone's saying, do you sing? Are you singing when you're on stage? Or are you miming? And didn't feel like I was doing the full shebang. I wanted to do it properly if I was gonna do it. So I went and had singing lessons and she was like, yeah, everything's fine, but you're very quiet. So I was like singing really quietly and like, and I was like twiddling with my hands and just like hated it. But over time, sort of, she really helped me build up my confidence, just going and having lessons and lessons and lessons. And then I sort of brought it all together, and again, with time and keep doing it and plenty of rehearsal and stuff, my confidence grew. And then I watched so many music videos and documentaries and things, pick up on her mannerisms and all the things that she does. Because I do think little things like that really do make all the difference when you're doing a performance and things. And then came the costumes, which my mum made, luckily. My mum knows how to work a sewing machine. The first one was the Toxic Air Hostess. We recorded the music video and we'd pause it and try and pause it so the little fuzzy lines, you know when the lines come up, was like not blocking the costume. So we'd just get a little bit and we'd go, right, she's got that like that, okay, that needs to. And it was literally, that's how we did it. And then the rest came along after that. My mum's made them all and she's been really cool. Circus is one of my favourite songs as well. That was one of the first songs that I started doing the tribute side of things to. I was learning the circus routine. That was the first dance routine that I started to break down with my friend who was a choreographer. And we had the red outfit made because it was at the time that she did the circus tour. So I'll always wear that one for circus. I think it's the most iconic. There's only two types of people in the world. The ones that entertain and the ones that observe. Well, baby, I'm a put on a show kind of girl. Don't let the back seat, gotta be first. Quite a sensitive person, and there were stories about me that had gone out, and stupidly I approved them, but I suppose you live and learn, and it was all very fabricated. It didn't sit right with me because it wasn't quite true, and it just made me feel really bad for quite a while. If I listened to everybody online, I'd have the world's biggest complexes. You're too fat, you're too ugly, your teeth are wonky. Oh my God, the stuff that people come out with, you just think you would never say that to a person if you met them in real life. But I suppose over time I've grown a bit of a thicker skin and now I just go, oh, whatever. You know, I do a lot of charity events and stuff, and they're there for the charity events, and it raises awareness of what you do. And so in that respect, it can be really good as well. So yeah, I definitely get a feel of what Britney must go through with it on a much smaller scale. That is just so typically me. so long, everybody was always asking me, have you met Britney? And I was always like, no, I really want to meet her, but I don't think I ever will. And it got to a point where I thought, I'm never actually going to meet, she's this massive superstar, I'm never going to get to meet her. And I went to Vegas last year in October and I got to meet her and it was amazing. She held like a competition for best costume and I went in my toxic outfit because it was Halloween. And then Felicia came over, who's Britney's personal assistant, and she came over and was like, I have seen your picture, I had to come over and say hello, Britney's gonna freak out, I need to get a picture of you. And I was like, Felicia, can I have a picture with you? Like, I know who you are. So I had a picture with Felicia, and then the next thing, Britney's dad came over with Britney's mum and they were like, oh, we wanted to come and introduce ourselves to you, it's so nice to meet you. And I was like, oh my god, Britney's mum and dad. And they were going, we can't believe how much you look alike. And it was such a huge thing for me, because everybody has their own self-doubts and things like that, and I have days where I go, oh, I don't look anything like her, my makeup's not right, and all this. So for Britney's mum and dad and her assistant and her team to come over and go, you look so much like Britney, that for me was like the ultimate confirmation. That was like, I couldn't have asked for that. That was incredible. Her security team came over and was like, oh, we're gonna take you backstage to meet Britney, she wants to have a picture with you. And I was like, oh my god, I can't believe this is happening. So we went backstage, and obviously I got to meet her and have a picture with her, which was really, really cool. One of my biggest fears was meeting, if I ever did get to meet Britney, if she was like, who are you? What are you? Or if she was really rude to me. Like, obviously I don't know her in person, so that was one of my biggest fears, thinking if I put all this time and effort into portraying this person and learning about this person and doing this act for this one particular person, I've basically dedicated the last like nearly 10 years to dressing up and being Britney as a job. If I went and met her and thought, and she was really rude to me, oh my god, I'd have been devastated. But she was so lovely, so it just filled me with so much energy, and I was like, ah, oh, Vegas is amazing.
You wanna hot body, you wanna Bugatti, you wanna Maserati, you better work, bitch.
Work, bitch, oh my god, when I first heard that I was like, oh my god, how am I gonna do this? And her routines and everything, I was like, Britney's back, she's doing amazing routines, and I've got a lot of work to do, basically was my thoughts on it. But again, it just comes down to hard work and learning it and learning it. Even now, I sometimes do mess up my routine for work. I'm getting to a point where I think I've got it down, but yeah, I've swapped and changed it around that much because it's so energetic. I mean, just, it's like bang on when Britney does it, and I'm a bit of a perfectionist. I want it to be just like when Britney does it. So it definitely means get to work, bitch.
Hold your head high, fingers to the sky. They're gonna try.
My plans for the next 3 years is to be out there and doing as much Britney stuff as I can, cram it all in and really enjoy myself. And then as I start to get to 30, I'll probably look at having children and settling down for family life, which bores the hell out of me, to be honest. Hopefully I'd still be able to do bits of Britney stuff, but I don't want to be one of these that's really old and past it and still dressing up like a pop star. I'm not a girl.